this Raspberry Pi case. Essentially, a mini computer without a case. So, like a phone without the screen or housing. This kind of kit is not for everyone. This will appeal to those who like to tinker and build over simple. Accessories, downloads, and upgrades, one of which is an HDMI adapter for this DMG case, which I have bought separately. is the same size as the original Nintendo Game Boy. Same design as well. But some clear differences. Here is the Raspberry Pi 4. And you can see I have fitted the HDMI adapter to the side and added some copper and aluminium heat sinks on the main chips. Cooling these computer boards is something consider when housing them in such small cases. The Raspberry Pi 3 was fine with passive cooling. That is, cooling without using a fan, simply by adding metal plates on the chips. The Raspberry Pi 4 needs a fan for heavy usage. Like you can see, the inside of this case includes a fan. Here is the back of the case. It contains this rechargeable battery, powerful enough to run the board for a few hours. Maybe 3 to 4, depending on what game you're playing. Now you can see the various components the case includes, and although this might look a bit daunting at first, it's actually pretty simple. I recommend looking at some of the steps in the guide on the company's website, or many tutorial videos with clear instructions and step-by-step guides. This video might serve a double purpose, and as well as relaxing you, might also help you to put one of these together. I'm adding the fittings to the Raspberry Pi. Just drop it in carefully so everything lines up. It seems okay. Next, we need to connect this ribbon cable at the bottom into the SD card slot bottom of the board. this is essentially an extension, so you can access the card from the outside. And that's our first step. The board is now sitting as it should. Inside the case. Now, this module sits on top and slots in very satisfyingly into that multi-pin connector. It's very secure. We have to connect these two cables. They can be a bit fiddly to thread through and press in correctly, but be patient and never use too much force. These are the two back buttons, L and R, which we will access through the back case. I'll connect this ribbon cable. Now we have to screw in the HDMI board underneath. And technically I should have done this before closing the fan housing. But it works. And now four screws will secure the fan board on top of the Raspberry Pi. This is also how all the elements connect to the Pi. Here we have the on and off switch. Currently, it's not connected to the battery, so we can make sure it's making a good connection. And you might not need all the accessories in the box. And now we just have to connect this back panel and the battery through this little connector here. The screws are still inside the case, so I can just drop it on. Help line up that battery connector with these tweezers, and then press it. SD card slot on the side. I've downloaded a custom image and added some games from my collection. And now we can power it on for the first time. If the SD card is formatted properly, should eventually start up after a bit of waiting. Ah, this is a good sign. I'm going to dim the lights for this. It's not something I knew how to do before this video. So, always picking up new skills. As you can see, the Raspberry Pi 4 can cover a lot of systems from 8-bit and below, all the way up to PlayStation 1 and some PSP games. And this is one of my favorite games on DOS. Amok. I remember playing a demo of this from a magazine CD, and it was only the first two levels, but I spent hours on it. I remember it being very difficult. Luckily, in this full version of the game, I have found a difficulty setting, which makes the experience much more enjoyable. This game starts you off underwater and then moves you on to a ground operation level. Now, as you can imagine, this being something of a DIY case, everything is not perfect out of the box. You will sometimes be required to assign the controls, and sometimes find that there is no way to do so. Here, however, everything seems to be available. Most of these handhelds rely on RetroArch in the background. RetroArch is a compilation of console emulators with very extensive customizable settings. The interface you use on this game is overlaid on top of RetroArch, and so that explains why, when I leave this game later, you won't recognize the menu. Now you can see, in this first underwater level, we have to tackle sharks that seem to have a grudge against us and can destroy us very easily. dispensing with them. That's the first level. I'll quickly show you some of the second level when on the ground. And then I will show you a couple more games before. Subscribing and leaving a like and a comment if you did enjoy it. See, we are now firmly on the ground, hunting soldiers and avoiding mountains and rocks. Here is some sort of structure which we can blow parts of. This is another game I played from a demo disc. I used to challenge my friends to try and get through the various levels. And although this machine can do a lot of consoles, I found range of games was one of the most exciting ones to explore, as these are games I grew up with. Again, here we have some controls mapped. We could go into RetroArch and configure those controls, assign new keyboard controls to the buttons available. Here you can see some of my favorite games. But strangely, Wipeout has not been added to my favorite list yet. What a travesty. Fear not. I can find it and show you how it runs on this machine. It's mostly playable, with a few hiccups here and there on the sound. recently got the Design Republic art book, the company responsible for the look and feel of Wipeout, and I love that book. So many good designs and ideas, concepts. Only about the art of Wipeout, but unfortunately it only occupies a few pages. And now we are back on RetroArch. LCD, volume, L and R, and the battery pack. I bought this case during the Christmas period, and Experimental Buy were kind enough send me this nice yellow case as a gift. And this is not my first Pieboy DMG. I have bought a second one, as I'm planning to use the first one as a gift for someone. See.